So, this is a MacBook Pro that I got for free. Let's find out if it's any good. So before we get started, I just want to thank Skillshare for sponsoring this video. Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of classes in design, business, technology, and more. I have a link in the description below that will give you a free trial, and I'll have more information for you at the end of this video, so make sure to stay tuned for that. So you may have noticed this computer crop up in a couple of my videos over the past month or so, and that's because I've had this computer for about a month, and I haven't made a video on it yet. There's a very good reason for that. I forgot to make the video. I kept putting it off, so now I'm gonna do it. Way too late, but I'm still doing it, so it counts. So basically, the story behind this computer is my friend's dad had this water-damaged MacBook Pro. His wife spilled water all over it, and the thing apparently stopped working, so he came to me asking if I could help him find a new computer, which I did. And while I was searching for the new computer, I asked if I could have the old one for parts, because even with a dead logic board, you can still have a lot of useful parts on an old MacBook Pro. The keyboard, the top case, all of the metal parts would be fine. There's brackets and screws. So I was certain that there were plenty of usable parts on this computer. So he said, sure, you can have it. I don't want it anymore. So when I got it home, I pulled off the bottom case, pulled out the logic board to clean it off, and I could see a little bit of corrosion, but really not too much. So I was wondering why the thing had died so suddenly. So after I cleaned off the logic board, I put the computer back together and I figured, hey, you know what? Let's just plug it in on the off chance that it works. And you can probably guess by the fact this video exists that yes, it did work. It turned right on straight away with no issues. So at this point, I let the owner know that there was water damage. I could see visible water damage on the underside of the logic board, but that the computer would still work. And he said, you know, at this point, the thing is old, let's just move on. So now I have this computer. Didn't have a hard drive or RAM, so I had to supply that myself. But other than that, this was a free, fully functional MacBook Pro. So what MacBook Pro is it? Well, the specs of mine are as follows. This is a late 2011 13-inch MacBook Pro. My model has the 2.4 GHz Intel Core i5. I upgraded the RAM after the fact to 8 GB of DDR3. I also upgraded the storage with a 120 GB SSD from SanDisk. Graphics are handled by Intel HD Graphics 3000, and they output to a 1280 by 800 13-inch display. So, for a free laptop, this is really pretty decent. It's supported under High Sierra, not Mojave, although I will be working on trying to get this running Mojave with the patches that have come out. But even just running High Sierra, this thing actually is pretty solid. The only thing that really impedes usability is, as I mentioned earlier, there was a little bit of corrosion on the logic board, so this doesn't really affect performance, but it's not the only sign of water damage this computer has. The main one is the trackpad. So, as you might expect, being a primary point of contact when you spill liquid across a laptop, the trackpad is acting up a little bit. Now, all of the gestures and the touch surface work perfectly fine, but the issue is it doesn't click all the time. It takes a couple of tries, and clicking and dragging really doesn't work at all. So I've had to go through this workaround through accessibility where you can enable three-finger drag, which pretty much eliminates that problem. And I've also turned on tap to click, so if I don't get it with the press to click, I can always just tap. Now obviously this isn't ideal, and it is certainly more than a little bit annoying when just browsing the internet. However, on a free MacBook Pro that does have signs of water damage, I'm not gonna put another $30 or $40 into the trackpad. I'm comfortable putting that into storage and RAM because, of course, you can take out the SSD and use it on whatever you want, but the trackpad is certainly more specialized. The only other thing that I did have to replace was the hard drive data cable. Now, this is not entirely uncommon. A lot of unibody MacBook Pros have data cable failure. I've replaced several of them in the past, And I'll be honest, it's really not that annoying. It cost me, I think, $6 with free shipping to replace that. So really, all in, we're at $6 plus $30 for the SSD plus the RAM I had already. Now, I know you guys make fun of me for having a lot of RAM around, but I am actually running low. This RAM chip, interestingly enough, is a crucial 8GB DIMM that I bought in 2011 for my 2011 MacBook Pro, which was not this exact one, but very similar. And I upgraded the RAM, so I bought just the one 8GB chip. And interestingly enough, 7 years later, it's worth the exact same amount on Crucial.com because RAM prices are ridiculous. So how does this machine run? Well, apart from the trackpad issues that I mentioned earlier, this thing is pretty damn great. The Cinebench scores are somewhere in the low 200s, which is pretty similar to that of the earlier 13-inch Retina MacBook Pros. So performance-wise, this thing does a pretty decent job. The only thing that really gets in the way, for me at least, is the displays. And this goes for really all unibody MacBook Pros. They are definitely starting to show their age. 1280 by 800 is... it's not great. Obviously, for free, I am more than happy to overlook this, as the viewing angles and the colors are pretty decent, actually. This machine is fantastic for watching YouTube and Netflix and browsing the internet, as well as word processing, which is very easy because it has the same keyboard that everything else has. So while it does well for browsing the internet and watching Netflix when it's sat on a table, if you're sitting down with a blanket on your lap or in bed, this is not recommended. And this is more to do with the design of unibody MacBook Pros, but they have only one vent on the case for all cooling. That's for both intake and exhaust. So if it's blocked even a little bit, the cooling just completely melts down and the thing gets to about a billion degrees and the fan starts screaming. So you're definitely going to want to keep this well ventilated. Now, the other thing is the condition of my machine. Because it's not great, there's pretty noticeable dings and dents around all of the corners of this machine. I'd actually more call them scuffs than dents because they're not really like deep in the metal, they're just kind of these scrapes and scraps all over the corners. Now, the upside of this is there aren't really any major dents or gouges. I see a lot of these MacBook Pros with gigantic dents in the corners that are really, really, really unsightly. So I can make do with scuffs. I'm just glad there aren't any gigantic dents. But apart from those things, I'm really happy with this MacBook Pro. So I don't really plan on selling or giving away this MacBook Pro, and there's two main reasons. The first is that it was free and I have very little money invested in it, so I might as well keep it. And the second is I wouldn't really feel good about selling or giving away a computer that has signs of water damage. And especially with those very noticeable issues with the trackpad, I don't feel comfortable giving a computer that might crap out at any moment to someone who needs one. If you're looking at buying one of these outright, they usually go for under $300 on eBay. If you can find one in the $200 range, that's kind of the sweet spot for these 2011s with the Core i5s. You can stick SSDs, upgrade the RAM, and you've got yourself a really nice budget MacBook. So before I finish out today's video, I just wanted to talk a little bit more about Skillshare. So for the past 5 years or so, I've been using Final Cut Pro. That's what I've edited every single video that I've made for this channel on. So when Skillshare reached out to me about sponsoring a video and offered me access to all of their courses and their premium membership, I was very interested because I've always wanted to learn how to use Adobe Premiere, but I've never really wanted to do it all on my own. So I went on Skillshare and I just looked up Adobe Premiere and I found just absolute piles of courses. So Skillshare Premium is less than $10 a month, and if you use the link that I have in the description that they've given me, that will give you a free 2-month trial of Skillshare Premium. So head down to the description and you will find all of the information for that. So anyway, thank you guys for watching. I do hope that you go and check out those links in the description below, as I found these courses to be very, very helpful, And with that, I will get right back into the conclusion of this video. So that'll do it for today's video. As usual, make sure to follow me on Twitter at Luke Miani, and don't forget to join my subreddit. The link is in the description below. And of course, make sure to comment, like, and subscribe. And I will see you guys in the next video. We'll be right back.